Guys, welcome back to another video. Today we have something a little bit older for you from KSC. It's another one of the pistols from my collection, and it's one that I've sort of been saving because it's an old girl. You don't see these very often, and this one has got a few choice little bits and pieces on it which you don't see very often either. So this is the SP2022. From Sig Sauer. If you don't know what that looks like, it looks like one of these. So this was Sig's first sort of go at a polymer frame pistol in real steel. And this was KSC's interpretation of what was made. So you can see we've got the original manual in here, which is nice. And this is an old pistol. This is not a new system. So here is what we have here. So this is the Sig SP2022. Not made in 2022, it's worth mentioning. This is just the model number. Now, this one is again made by KSC. Generally, they are all polymer. This one, however, is wearing a Shooter's Design aluminium slide and outer barrel, and it looks so good for it as well. So really, really nice. This has a polymer lower frame and obviously a metal slide and metal controls as well, all which look very similar to Sig based products. So you can see we have Sig Pro on the grip here. What I also got in the box are a couple of mags, which have already been used. I've also got some spares. Basically, whenever there are spares available, I buy them up because obviously they don't make spares for this anymore because they don't make the gun anymore. So whenever there's some available, I buy them just in case so I can keep this running. So let's have a quick look at it then, shall we? So you can see it's a kind of compact. I would say it's similar size to a Glock 19. Now the build itself, like I said, the original pistol would have had a plastic slide and plastic outer barrel with sort of metal sights. This has the metal sights on it from the original pistol, but again, this is wearing a Shooter's Design slide here. It is, like I said, a polymer frame, and that is true to the real steel pistol. We have, I believe, is a metal trigger, and we've also got metal controls here as well, all around. Magazines are really nice. This uses the newer System 7 from KSC, which doesn't have the sort of two-piece nozzle. It just has a normal standard plastic nozzle, which is what we see on most modern pistols now. And they're actually marked Sig Pro 9mm on the back, on the side there. Obviously, you've got all the markings on the back here as well. But again, nice that they included that on the side there because they don't do that on many. In classic KSC fashion as well, we have metal feed lips on the top of the magazine. So looking at the pistol itself, we've got these sort of semi-integral grips, which are removable. From what I understand, you can change these for real steel ones. However, I don't know why you would need to, because these are very good quality and the stippling is very good. The frame has a unique sort of brown kind of look to it, which is a little unusual. And the slide has a sort of slightly blue hue to it as well, which is unusual. We can see on the side here, it says frame made with rail. And again, this is just mimicking the real steel pistol here. You can see it says on the side here, remanual before use. And underneath we have a serial number as well. I'm not sure if these are unique or whether these are just, you know, they're all the same. Unfortunately, there's not a lot of information out there about this because it wasn't a very well known and popular model, so it didn't really do that well, which is why there's not many out there. So let's have a quick look inside and see what we've got then. So we're just going to cock the pistol, and we have to go back quite far on this one. Then we have to push the pin out the side here. So back to here, push the pin out, and then that releases our slide catch. Now, a slide catch is of an alloy. It's not steel. It doesn't have any steel in it at all. It is just all sort of pot metal. The slide should now come off the front. We'll have a look at the slide in a minute. Looking at the lower then. Now, if any of you are familiar with the Western Arms system, this will look all quite familiar. Again, it's quite an old style system where basically the hammers were made of an alloy and had a hardened steel pin inside them, which that pin makes contact with this little striker here, which then pushes forwards and hits the hammer, which is the little sort of spring-loaded hammer here, onto the back of the magazine, which then obviously shoots gas through the system. And again, this was KSC's sort of System 7, which they adopted into lots of different models of theirs. It also has sort of like a reset here as well, which again, it's quite a cute, nice little system. And as far as I'm aware, all these parts in here are steel. They're not of any kind of alloy construction. The frames, should I say, are alloy, but the main components in here are all steel. You can see the front rail here is obviously a metal piece held in with various pins. Same on the rear here. I've never had this apart because, well, I know they're a bit of a Swiss watch inside. I didn't want to take it apart. We have a decocker on the side here, which again, just press down and that will decock the pistol. And obviously you can then double and single action this if you need to. So let's have a quick look at the slide assembly. Now, again, it's worth bearing in mind that this is the shooter's design slide. So this is not as you would get one if you were to find one of these. This was just very fortunate that this had the shooter's design slide in it, which I must say is a really, really nice bit of kit. I have messed around with this quite a lot. I wasn't the first owner of this either, and it has virtually no wear on it whatsoever, apart from a little bit on the leading edge of the outer barrel here. Underneath, you can see we've got our large rear blowback unit and nozzle. The nozzle actually says S234 on it, which would indicate the SP2340 model, which we saw a bit more of, but they're still quite rare and you don't see them very often. You can see we've got our recoil guide rod here with some buffers here. Now, we have O-rings and washers basically in here. This wasn't me, this was the previous owner that did this. And that sort of just added a bit more tension to the recoil spring. We can remove the recoil spring here. You can see it's a reasonably stiff recoil spring. We can remove the outer barrel. And you can see something a bit unusual here with the outer barrel here is that we've got this little brass bush through here. Now again, if any of you guys are familiar with Western Arms systems, this is very similar. So the KSC system, the System 7 that they adopted with this, was sort of a bit of a mishmash of stuff that was being made at the time by KSC and Western Arms, by the looks of things. They sort of adopted a few of their ideas. This is an aluminium outer barrel. It's all one piece. And again, you know, CNC machined, really lovely. You can see here that we have the standard KWA/KSC style hop unit, which are not very good. This one does have an aftermarket hop rubber in here. I'm not familiar with what type it is, but you can see to adjust the hop, we rotate this round and that adjusts the amount of hop that's given to the hop rubber. You need a tool usually to get in there to do it, but you can obviously get hold of it and do it like this, no problem. So looking inside the slide, you can see we've got a little bit of wear on the inside slide, but really not a lot, considering that this, I'm assuming, has had a bit of use. It's really not bad at all. Our nozzle, you can see if we retract that back there. Now, this is one of the main things I've done to this, past being the factory pistol, is I have modified and fitted a O-ring piston head in here. Now, the reason why I did this is KWAs and KSCs use these style piston heads, which are, they're rubber, but they degrade extremely quickly and they literally fall apart. When I got this, it was supposed to be a fully working pistol, and as in common fashion with stuff I get, it wasn't really working at all. You had to really use it on black gas for it to even cycle. And the previous owner had informed me of that, but he had just assumed that it was just an outdated design, I think. However, it would have worked perfectly had it had a new one of these fitted, which I did initially fit in, but I knew it was going to happen again. So I fitted a O-ring style piston head in there. Runs fantastically with that in there now. The nozzle is a little unusual. It has two return springs on this either side, which is very unusual. And you can see it has a metal valve inside, which again is non-adjustable, so you do need to change the valve out if you want to adjust the FPS on these. But yeah, it's an interesting design. But again, this is what we see from most gas blowback pistols now. It's worth bearing in mind that this was fairly revolutionary at the time. Early KSC designs had a long brass tube coming through, and the actual nozzle, that brass tube stayed the same with a little probe on the end, and the actual nozzle was a plastic piece which slid up and down. It worked fine, but it was quite complex considering needed lots of sort of work to make sure it worked correctly, and you know, it was had to be looked after. So let's reassemble. So barrel back in, pop our recoil spring back in and guide rod. We can then offer that up onto the pistol itself to slide the slide back on. It's worth bearing in mind you can see the opening meet there. What I normally do here is just pop this in to start off with, just to hold it in place, otherwise the barrel gets stuck back in the slide and then it doesn't come back normally. So pull it back until they line up, and then you can drop this back in, and that'll then hold that in. One of the only things I dislike about it, I would say, is the fact that the hammer almost fully disappears inside the slide here. It's just the way the system works. As far as I'm aware, the real steel does not do this. It's just the way they operate. So let's have a little look then and see how it works. So very snappy. Very loud as well. Since I changed that piston head, absolutely no problems at all, and it functions great. So it works really well. One of the other interesting parts of this pistol is we do have these triangular shaped mag ejection, which I believe is transferable. So you can swap that over to the other side if need be. Obviously we have our decocker and slide release on this side as well. So not that it's really necessary because you can't buy this pistol anymore, but let's FPS check it and see what it's pushing. Because the earlier KFC models were not really running particularly high FPS because they were mainly made for the Japanese market. So I'm expecting sort of 250-ish, something like that. But we'll get the chrono out and see what we got. Okay, so about to load the 2022. And one of the nice things I've always liked about KWA and KSC is that the early models had these locks, so you could pull the follower down and it would lock down in position. There was a little button here to hold it in, which is great because then you can just load them in straight in the top here by using speed loader, and they literally just drop straight in. Nothing at all needed to push them in at all. They just go straight in. So a really nice system. Gonna put 5 rounds in so we can see what we've got. It's worth bearing in mind as well, because these are metal feed lips, you don't just wanna hit the button and they shoot back up. You want to make sure you slowly allow it to go up like that. Otherwise, you'll end up smashing the top BB and then it will just jam the gun. Okay. 298.4, 295.5, 292.5, 287.3, 282.0. It's actually a bit higher than I expected, to be fair. It was just on standard green gas. It's worth bearing in mind that obviously being a plastic pistol originally and being a Japanese model, you would have expected to be using it in duster gas, which would have probably been around the 240 FPS level. But yeah, so we're averaging 0.73 joule there. So one thing I don't talk about a lot in any of my videos are the manuals that come with these things, because usually, as anyone's aware, airsoft manuals are normally terrible and are just a bit of a waste of time anyway. However, early KSC stuff came with these really nice little manuals which had quite interesting little drawings in. You can see this is a Japanese model with all the Japanese bits and pieces in here. Again, it gives you sort of breakdown how to disassemble, which again is a really nice thing. You've got your full diagram here with all part numbers, which is great. Not that you can get this stuff anymore, of course. And then right in the back, which I found really interesting, In the rear here, you can see we have KSC real gun information, which again, I think is a really nice little touch. Whether or not any of these or all of these were made in Airsoft, I doubt. I haven't seen any of these other than the VP70 and obviously the Glock 17. I think I have seen the STI Eagle 5.1 before. I know that the P99 was made by Maruzen as a non-blowback. However, Maruzen and KSC, as far as I'm aware, are not associated, so I don't know why that would be. But I haven't seen any other models of these. The Smith & Wesson Sigma was made by KWC, sorry. And I haven't seen any other ones either. So, but interesting to put this in here. Again, didn't need to. Again, real gun information on the back here as well. We can see there's the Mark 23. Now, I know they did make that. Obviously, they did make this one. I don't know what this one is. I'd love to get my hand on an M40 if they did make it. I don't think they did. We've got the FN57, which obviously they did make. Well, Marui did make. And then we've got the Baby Eagle as well, which, again, you know, or the Jericho as it's known. I'm not sure whether they made that. What was quite interesting as well is you've got these extra bits and pieces down here, which, again, whether or not they made them for this, I don't know. They were made for real steel. And then, obviously, you know, the real gun information on here as well, which, obviously, we can't read any of it. But I just thought it was quite interesting to show you that. Again, this was the Japanese model which came with this, so maybe it's only the Japanese stuff which came with these. So there we go. There is the KSC SP2022, improved by Shooter's Design with the Shooter's Design slide here. One of those in my collection that I would probably never get rid of because it's just such an interesting looking thing. SIG handguns, I've always liked, but they never really fit me very well. I find them very sort of top heavy. And there's quite high bore axis on these. I really prefer the Glocks for the lower bore axis. But again, you know, it's something really different for the collection. And yeah, it's one of those ones I would probably never look to get rid of. But let me know what you think in the comments, guys. Have you seen one of these before? Have you had one before? What were your experiences of it? Have you seen any of the other ones that I showed you in that that leaflet in Airsoft before? If you have, I'd love to hear what your experiences were and where you see them, because I'd love to know if they were actually out there and they exist, because if they are, I'm going to try and find some. Any questions, fire away in the comments, and I'll see you guys in the next video.